professor might just remind you that, you know, spirituality and the first part of that spirituality is also about more the evening practice.
Yeah, sure. May I have a word? I think it doesn't seem to work. Thank you. In my view, I saw Sridhara stating is that spirituality is an essential component of being a great leader. You know, generally we talk of three kinds of Qs, the IQ, the EQ, and the SQ, right? In my view, IQ has to do with your business. The EQ has to do with the organization and people. The SQ has to do with the community at large out there. Whether we like it or not, we make an impact. And since we make an impact, we have a responsibility. The other constituents, whether it's the community at large or the society. And it is that ability to have that as part of your purpose, part of your philosophy. I often talk about two kinds of entities, organizations and institutions. If you excel in the first two, what you build is an organization. But if your SQ component is also high, what you end up creating is an institution. And those leaders who have the aspiration and the capability to create institutions have to necessarily have SQ. And if you are going to lack on that, you may end up creating excellent organizations, but which won't be an institution.
Great. I saw Professor Sinha wanted to ask one question, so one last question.
Okay. So primarily on EQ, does the panel think that emotional intelligence is a part of the list of competencies of the leaders, successful leaders, or EQ has a component somewhere which makes a successful leader? Or does it lose a sense in uncertain times, or it still stays with the competency? You tried to answer.
Okay, great, thank you. With that, I think I will draw this discussion. We are getting timed out, I think, so let's take one last question. This table, yeah.
I wrote the questions very clearly, but halfway through it was answered, but I still have the question to ask, probably to concur or whatever. Stephen Covey's definitions really has come very strongly to me regarding managing and leadership. When he said, while it is how to do is managers, what to do is the leader. So that part was answered, but I still have going with the topic here, developing leaders with uncertain times. And again, Stephen Covey's definition of managing is managing the complexities, while leading is managing the change. So if leading is managing change is accepted as a definition, will it matter whether it's uncertain or certain? Because the job of the leader himself is to manage change. Certainty, uncertainty is only a change that happens in the environment. So do you agree? So I still feel that if it's a leader, whether it's certainty or uncertainty, doesn't matter. Because the leader's definition itself is to manage change from the outside perspective. Your comment?
Yeah, I mean, from what you said makes sense. Yeah, please.
Actually, I think I spoke about it when I talked about it doesn't matter in what situation you need to be a leader. And today, that flexibility and adaptability become very, very key to successful leaders. And therefore, I personally agree with you that a leader manages change, and therefore, if that change results in managing uncertain times, he should be successful in that. As much as he or she should be successful in managing good times. So personally, I agree with you.
Can I have one last question? What if we have a cross command, I think perhaps leaders, I think Stephen mentioned about it.
Was, do you think there is a difference between a manager and a leader? If there is, then the manager manages the change. Leader originates the change. He is not one who only manages the change. I think there is a difference in it.
I think I will draw it here. And
I think
over the dinner.
Can I have just one last question?
If you insist.
I just wanted to know how much does the reputation of a country matters when you're talking about global leaders? How easy is it for an Indian to become a global leader versus a Western person or a Chinese person? Is there a difference from your experience?
Great, and so thanks a lot to the entire audience. I think those were some great questions. A big thanks to this panel. I learned a lot today, and thank you. This was really, really very insightful. Thank you.
I'm sure that for each one of us, this program was an insightful and enriching experience. We look forward to your continuous feedback and engagement with the organizers. Now, on behalf of BIMTEC, People Matters, NHRD, and Aon Hewitt, I once again thank leaders of the session for their fantastic efforts, all the panelists for taking out time from their busy schedules to share their experience with us. A big round of applause to you, our audience. Please join us for dinner and coffee.